In this video, I'm going to show you how to build a simple audio amplifier that can power nearly any speaker. For less than $3 in parts, it gets surprisingly loud. This tutorial was supported by the Great Courses Plus. In my previous videos about amplifiers, I showed you how to make a simple op-amp circuit that can power headphones, and another one where I showed you how to make a powerful Class D design. But what if you just want a simple amplifier that can drive a speaker without all the fancy switch mode circuitry? The LM386 is an all-in-one Class AB audio amplifier chip, and it's the easiest way to power a speaker. This chip has been around for decades, and it's still used to this day in products like computer speakers and portable stereos. So everyone who works with electronics needs to know about this chip. The maximum power output is roughly 1 watt, which doesn't sound like much in a world full of deceptive marketing, but trust me, 1 watt going into a speaker is more than enough power to fill an entire living room full of sound. The first thing you're going to need is a 3.5mm audio plug attached to a cable. There are many ways to get this. You could solder wires onto a plug, or cut up an extension cable, but I think the cheapest way to do this is to just cut up headphones from the dollar store. After I was done being a stripper, I used some sandpaper to remove the insulation on the left and right signal wires, and I soldered on some thicker wire to make it easier to connect the cable to a breadboard. I also twisted the two ground wires together. Next, we're going to implement the simplest possible stereo-to-mono conversion circuit. It's just putting 1 kilo ohm resistors in series with the audio channels, then joining the ends together. Now, this is definitely not the best way to do stereo-to-mono, as we're just averaging the signals here, but the point of this project is to create the simplest amplifier possible, and this trick works surprisingly well. Next, you're going to need an LM386 chip. They are so popular that you can get them from anywhere that sells electronic components. If you want, you could get them from Amazon for less than a dollar a piece. Just make sure you get the DIP 8 version that's suitable for breadboarding, not the surface mount version. I want you to be aware that there are a couple of versions of the LM386 out there that have different input voltage and output power ratings. For example, the LM386N-1 works from 4 to 12 volts, and the -4 works from 5 to 18 volts. For this project, I'm going to be using the LM386N-4. It'll give you the flexibility to crank up the supply voltage for the full watt of power. Okay, here's the partial schematic. For the power, I'm going to use a 9-volt battery, but I really recommend using something like a 12-volt lead-acid battery or a 12-volt wall adapter, because that'll let you turn up the volume louder without distortion, and the circuit can drain a 9-volt battery very quickly. I also recommend putting a 100 microfarad capacitor in parallel with the power supply, reasonably close to the chip, so that the amplifier can instantly get the power it'll need for loud bass notes. This capacitor is also used for filtering, and it'll help make sure that noise from the power supply doesn't get passed into the audio amplification circuitry. 47 microfarads or higher will work just fine, and I used 100 microfarads just because that's what I had available. On the output of the LM386, you should put a 1000 microfarad capacitor or higher. This will ensure that no DC voltage could possibly get passed into your speaker, which would damage it. Don't be misled by crappy schematics that you find on the internet with low values like 100 microfarads. You want to use at least 1000 microfarads to guarantee good bass with a wide variety of speakers. If you want to know more about why, make sure you've watched my video on RC high-pass filters. Alright, let's power this thing up! Ugh, this metal sounds like Bieber. Okay, so what's going on here? The schematic I'm showing you is very similar to other schematics on the internet, but as you know, you can't trust everything you see on the internet. Let's look at the output on an oscilloscope to figure out what's going on. Okay, so we have what looks like a normal audio waveform, but on top of it there's a large amount of noise, and that's what's causing this horrible sound. Zooming in on the noise, you can see that it's about 2.2 MHz. That's literally 100 times higher than any frequency we should be seeing out of an audio amplifier. It turns out that our amplifier is oscillating, and we need to get all of this high-frequency garbage out of our feedback loop, so it's only amplifying audio frequencies. Now, normally what you'd do here is add an RC high-pass filter that'll send all the high-frequency current to ground, so it can't interfere with the audio. But I found an even simpler solution, and it works for all the speakers I tried it with. you can just put a 0.1 microfarad capacitor in parallel with the output, and it'll stop all the unwanted oscillation. Now the amplifier sounds exactly as it should, and you can see that the high frequency oscillation is gone. Now, to give you an idea of how loud this thing can go, I'm standing right next to the camera, and this is me just talking in my normal speaking voice. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to hear anything right now. Next, I'd like to give you a couple of close-up shots of the breadboard to give you some ideas of how you can build this thing. Keeping the wires as short as possible is the best way to keep unwanted noise out of your circuit. So yeah, that's it. For less than $3 in parts and a few minutes of your time, you can build an amplifier that'll work with any line-level audio source, like phones, MP3 players, and laptops. Now, are you interested in learning more about electronics? Check out the Great Courses Plus. It's a video streaming service with thousands of tutorial videos on every subject imaginable. Science, cooking, photography, investing, programming, they've got courses that teach pretty much anything you'd ever want to know. And most importantly, they have videos about electronics. I've checked out the lectures and it's good stuff. All the animations are really helpful for understanding things, and it's way better than the old school chalk on a blackboard approach. It's kind of like university without all the homework. It's all original content, not just stuff that you can find on YouTube, and they add new videos every month. I've worked out a deal where you can get a free month of unlimited video streaming by visiting thegreatcoursesplus.com/afrotechmods or just click on the link in the video description section to start your free trial. Thanks, everyone!